guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Ellen Henry, a circus performer and coach, and today I'm going to be showing you guys what I do to warm up my shoulders and my arms and my wrists and my flexibility so that I am ready to do a handstand session. So stay tuned. Apologies for the background noise. I am on a farm, so there are some nice birds in the background, maybe a crackling fire. Sorry about that, but enjoy. So first off, to start off with, we are going to do big circles going forwards a couple times, and then big circles going back. And then you want to do one arm going forward and one arm going back. And then the other way, swapping sides. Then you want to bring one arm across your body and use the other hand to pull it close to your body. Don't want your shoulder to come up too far. You want to push and resist it down. And then swapping sides. You can also do these stretches standing up. I'm just sitting down because, well, I have no excuse. I'm just lazy today. And then we're going to bring that hand up and behind our back, using our other hand to pull it over and to stretch it. With this stretch, you want to make sure that you're not arched, you make sure that you're standing up nice and tall. And then we're going to do the other side. You also want to make sure that your head is facing up nice and high and not hunched over. And then after that, alright, next you're going to want to stand up for this one. You're going to have your legs nice and wide, and then you're going to bring your arm up and over. You really want to feel this stretch through the side of your body, not the butt. You also want to rest your other hand on your leg to help stabilize you, and then you want to go over to the other side. If you have a particularly strong core, you can also bring your second hand off and hold that and get a bit of a core workout in there as well. And then we're going to come down and around to the other foot and back up again. And then we're going to go down and sweep across to the other foot and the other side again. Next we're going to come down to the ground and we're going to reach forward, middle and behind to really open up those hamstrings and to stretch them out. And we're going to walk our feet out, and we're going to walk them to really help stretch out those hamstrings. And you're also going to resist your hands into the ground and push your shoulders through as much as you can. Really try to stretch and open them up. Next, we're going to come down to the ground into a cobra. And then you're going to go back up into a downward dog, flicking between those two, really trying to open up and get a bit of mobility through your shoulders. Next, we're going to go back down into cobra, and we're going to go to each side, really trying to open up your sides and stretch them out. Next, we're going to come back into the middle and we're going to go out to child's pose. Put our hands down to the ground and really push your shoulders to the ground. After you've done that, you want to bring your hands together, pop them to one side, and to bring your shoulder down to the ground and really stretch out that entire lat of that side. This is a really good one to sort of like roll through the motions and really see where it stretches you the most. And do the same on the other side. Oh yeah. this one also cracks my back, which is so good. Next, we're gonna bring one hand underneath our bodies, resting our shoulder on the ground, and then bringing our other hand up and over our body. Here we're trying to twist and open up that thoracic spine. And really open up your thoracic. Then we'll do the same on the other side. After that, we're going to bring one of our legs in front of us and go out into a lunge. You really want to make sure that you're stretching and opening up that back hip. Next, you want to bring your bum back over your leg. And you want to bring your foot up to your bum. Really want to stretch and open up that hip again. Letting that come down. And you're going to straighten your front leg. And you can either point or flex your foot. And we really want to try and keep a flat back for this while stretching and opening up that hamstring. Next, you're going to bring that front foot parallel to your body. Hold it still with your hands, with your hand on your foot and your thigh, and you're going to try and straighten that back leg. Now, this one is a good indicator of how tight your glutes are. And as you can see, mine are quite tight at the moment, which is why I'm nowhere near flat to the ground. Now hold that for a little bit. Also, you're very welcome to go at this at your own pace and to hold each stretch for longer to really help open up and make those muscles nice and long. Next, you're going to slide out into the full squeeze. Now for this one, you want to really try and keep your hips as square as they can stay while also sliding out. Ooh, my hamstring's tight. Also try not to open up your hips and let your bum fall out to the side. Hold that for as long as you like. And then we're going to repeat that on the other side. So kneeling first, really stretching this side. Make sure you really squeeze your bum when you do this one as well. Stretching your leg is closer to you, make sure you bring it a little bit further out, and then hopefully you'll be able to feel the stretch a little bit more. team to split. Make sure you hold yourself up with your hands and really try and relax into it. Even if your splits are up here, as long as it's stretching, then that is really good. Some really good techniques for getting your splits a little bit flatter is to do the breathing, resisting, and releasing technique, where you resist against the ground, pushing away, and then relaxing and sinking into it. And then pushing away, and then sinking into it and relaxing. Next, we're going to slide out into straddle. Pointing our toes, and we're just going to go from side to side. Then we're going to bring our arm over the top and try and grab that foot while also keeping that opposite leg bump on the ground. You also don't want to be too closed over. You want to have that top arm right over the top of your head. And to the other side. To wiggle your hands out as far as they go forward and really try and sink into your pancake. Even if you're up here, as long as it's stretching, then that is really good. Once you've held that, you're going to walk back in. And now we're going to bring our legs together and we are going to do some compression lifts. This is really important for handstands because it'll help you when you're kicking up or when you're starting to press up. For the first one, we're going to do it with our legs together and our hands next to our knees. And you're going to want to think about drawing your core in and using that, as well as drawing your hips back into your body. And we're going to do 10 of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. If that was too easy for you, then you can move your hands out even further and do the exact same thing. 7, 8, 9, 10. You'll want to repeat those two sets again. Once you've done that, you're going to bring your legs out into a straddle and you're going to do the same thing but with your hands on the inside. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then once again, you're going to bring your hands out as far as you can get them and then do the same thing. And you'll want to repeat those twice through as well. This stretch is also really good to open up your shoulders and stretch your lats. You want to find something that you can put your hands on and you want to open up your shoulders, pushing them to the ground. But you don't want to arch your back. You want to keep that sucked in and you just want to stretch through your shoulders and your lats. Hold that one for about like 10 to 20 seconds depending on how tight you feel. And that's it for the stretching to get my body ready for handstands. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like because it shows me that you guys enjoy my content. Also, leave any handstand questions down in the comments below. Love to hear from you guys. And until next time, Circus fam.